Hello, Paul.
Hello.
I am going to ask you a few questions about how you and Mom met. You guys are going to have a 40th anniversary coming up on June 4th. So are you ready to answer some personal questions?
Shoot them at me.
Well, Mama, it looks like you and Daddy have a 40th anniversary coming up soon. What do you think about that?
I think it's great. It's just great to have somebody in your life as good as he's been to me and as much as we've loved each other.
So my first question is, how did you and Daddy meet?
Your Daddy and I, believe it or not, met on a blind date. Donnie Blue, he introduced us, and he was dating Shelby, my sister, and so when he came to pick her up, he learnt me and got acquainted and asked me how I would like to meet one of his friends, and I said it'd be okay, so he was actually a blind date.
Where was the first date at?
Where was the first date at? At the Cookville Drive-In.
Oh! Do you remember what movie you saw? You may not even remember the movie if you were on a first date.
Oh, no, I don't remember.
Where was your first date?
Oh, our first date was Crossville. We went to Crossville. He played in a bar, believe it or not. Uh-oh, maybe I shouldn't have said that. But he was young. Those guys, they was in a band. They was none of them drank or none of them was rowdy or anything. I went one night with him and I was terrified to death, afraid Daddy and Mama would find out where I went. And I was somewhat scared in there because I'd never been in a bar in my life. And that's, we just kept going there until one day I talked him into quitting.
What was your first impression of Mama when you met Mama?
She was a knockout.
I seen him walking through the yard. Of course, I was peeping out the window. I was peeping out the window because I thought, now, if I don't like the way this man looks, I'm going to run and hide. You know how we all do. So I liked what I saw, and I've been with him now for 40 years.
How long did it take before the first kiss?
Well, believe it or not, the night he brought me home, he kissed me goodnight.
Well.
Yep, that was fast, wasn't it?
What's the most memorable date that the two of you went on?
I would say it was down below the dam at Standing Stone.
Why was that memorable?
Well, we just went down there and talked about stuff. And this was after we'd been dating a while. And we seen things was getting serious.
I guess the one that stands out the most is the one where I was so terrified. We had went somewhere to eat out, and then we came back, and we always parked at Standing Stone under the bridge. You know, in those days, you did a lot of parking. There wasn't a lot of entertainment, so we liked to park and listen to music, and we fell asleep one night. It was way in the morning. We woke up, and oh my goodness, a huge snow was on. And I thought, oh my God, Daddy's gonna kill me. It's what, 3-4 o'clock in the morning? And I thought we wasn't gonna get out from under there because it was just all uphill. And we made it though. We made it and got out. And that was pretty scary. So I guess that one stands out a lot to me.
How did Daddy propose to you? Do you remember that night? Did you go on a date? Where were you at?
We had went on a date to Crossville, and we were on our way back, and he just asked me outright, will you marry me? I would love to spend the rest of my life with you.
Was he driving in the car? Did he stop?
No, he was driving. He was driving and took hold of my hand.
And did he have a ring?
At the time, he didn't have a ring.
So when it came down to the actual ring, did he get you a ring before you were married?
Oh, yes.
So when he actually put the ring on your finger, when did that happen?
That was probably, oh, just a few weeks after that. I think he actually had bought the ring, but he was waiting to get it sized and take me with him. So I think he wanted to actually ask me first if I would before he went and got it.
I just popped a question.
Did you take her somewhere to do that? Where were you guys at?
I don't remember where we was at. I don't think we went anywhere special.
Just popped the question.
Popped the question.
How long did you stay engaged before you got married?
I really don't know. 3 or 4 months, probably.
Mm-hmm. Back in the days before you had kids, what were some of the things that you guys enjoyed doing together?
Back before we had kids? Oh, your daddy always was a musician. So we went to a lot of musical events, square dances, and that kind of stuff. And then he became playing, picking in church, and that made our lives a lot happier. Not that we had any fusses or bickerings or thing, but you know, I just felt like that bar was dangerous, and of course I'd never been in one until I started going with him. And I was just actually going with him to be with him, not for the, you know, for the bar itself or anything, because none of us drank or anything like that. But I just went to be going with him because I enjoyed being with your daddy. And I told him, you know, this just don't seem right. We need to be in church. So we started going to church, and of course he would pick, you know, he'd started picking in churches and stuff, and never did go back into a bar anymore. That was it.
Well, about the only thing that we done was me a picking.
Did Mom Except, enjoy going to those shows with you?
Yeah, all except Sunday night. That was the only night we had left to, you know, go to the movies or just to be with each other.
Is there a song that played back then that you would consider y'all's song, or a song that when you heard it, you thought about her?
Linda on My Mind.
There's a lot of songs stands out, but I guess one in particular in that time, it came over the radio a lot. Of course, when we'd sit in park, we always listened to love songs, and we liked that kind of thing. So I guess it was Johnny Rodriguez, That's the Way Love Goes. I can hear that playing today.
What's something that Daddy does for you that just melts your heart? Just something that so sweet that may not mean much to anybody else, but to you, it's melts your heart.
Well, he does a lot of things your daddy does that melts my heart. Your daddy's a sweetheart. He's got so much love and compassion in him and all, but I guess the one thing that really pleases my heart or melts my heart is when I'm sick or don't feel good or, you know, things like that. He always just holds me tight and he prays for me. He prays that the Lord will heal me and just help me through whatever it is I'm going through. And to me, that's just one of the best things that any man can do for a woman, is to know that he has that kind of relationship with the Lord and that he is in my life. And I just feel blessed that I have somebody like that, that the Lord's placed somebody in my life like that.
Well, everything she does melts in my heart, especially now.
What is the best gift that Daddy has ever gotten for you? I'm sure there's been so many gifts over the years, but is there one gift that sticks out?
And I guess the one thing that would stand out would be a necklace that he bought me. As a matter of fact, I think I have it on. I don't part with it no more. It was this one right here. It's a piece of gold, and it says, "My greatest joy is loving you a lifetime." I mean, how much better can it get than that? And I think he means it with all his heart. And he also, of course, I got a little prayer box here, and he wrote a prayer out on a piece of paper, and that prayer's in there. But I keep that with me all the time.
Well, she's got me so much stuff, it's hard to choose which is the best.
What advice do you have all of us kids about what it takes to have a long-lasting marriage?
To be understanding and patient and just love each other.
I guess with us, we've always learned to say, you know, I'm sorry, and we've always learned to listen to each other's needs and respect those needs, and always say I love you, and one thing for sure is always have good communication with each other. Don't never stop having communication, because when you have that communication breakdown, it's going to be rough. So always communicate and talk to each other about everything.
Is there anything that you'd like to say to Daddy going into your 40th year with him?
I would just love to say to your Daddy that I feel like I'm the luckiest woman in the world, that God has blessed me with him, and that there is no end to the depths of my love for him. He's just been remarkable and been a good father. He's just a wonderful husband and grandpa, and God's just blessed him with so many good quantities, you know, and all of them. I love all of them. He's just so compassionate and loving and kind and respectful, and he's always been that way ever since I met him. And I love him deeply.
This has been the best 40 years, the happiest that I could imagine. You've been a wonderful wife, and I wish it'd last 40 more, but I know it won't, so I love you.
I've been throwing horseshoes over my left shoulder. I've spent most all my life searching for that four-leaf clover. Yet you run with me, chasing my rainbow. Honey, I love you too. That's the way love goes. That's the way love goes, babe. That's the music God made for the whole wide world to sing. It never gets old, it only grows. Losing makes me sorry. You say, honey, don't worry. Honey, I love you too. That's the way love goes. Honey, I love you too. That's the way love goes.
The best is yet to be. When our time has come, we will be as one. God bless our love. God bless our love. Grow old along with me. Two branches of one tree. Face the setting sun. When the day is done, God bless our love. God bless our love. Spending our lives together, man and wife together, world without end, world without end. Whatever fate decrees, we will see.